Hey everyone, I'm Howard Pinsky, and today I'm going to be showing you how you can create an interactive map using scroll groups in Adobe XD. And if you want to follow along, I'll leave a link in the description down below so you can download the sample file. Let's get to it. Grabbing the rectangle tool, I'm going to draw one out to fill this artboard. Then make sure it's at the back of the layer stack so the other elements can be seen. With the shape in place, we need an image. And maps can be found or generated from various places, including Adobe Stock, the Fancy Maps plugin, or a service like Snazzy Maps, which is where I generated this one that I'll drag straight in. Now, if I were to simply launch the preview of this prototype, it looks great, but no scrolling can take place just yet. So, with the map still selected, a scroll group can be created within the Properties Inspector, horizontally, vertically, or one that extends in both directions, which is what we'll want in this case. When a scroll group is created, the blue bounds determine what's visible immediately and what can be accessed upon scrolling. What's important to note is that the content inside the group needs to extend beyond those bounds in order for scrolling to take place. So, jumping into the map, I'll enlarge it in both directions to set how much of the area can be accessed. Perfect. Launching the prototype one more time will now let us pan around in any direction, either by clicking and dragging, using a trackpad, or a touch surface if you're previewing on a mobile device. Of course, our scrolling goodness doesn't have to stop there. Elements can be added into scroll groups at any point. So, switching over to my document assets, I've designed a few components that would look great on this map. Making sure I'm inside the scroll group, I'll start dragging these elements in and position them into place. Some in the visible area, and some outside so they can be accessed once scrolling takes place. With the new components added in, let's take one more look. Just like before, the map can be panned around, but since additional objects were added into the scroll group, those shift around with it. And as an added bonus, Lottie animations display beautifully, and wired up components can be interacted with as well. And that's how you can create an interactive map using scroll groups in Adobe XD. Hope you all enjoyed this video. Be sure to subscribe for more content, follow me on Twitter, and I'll see you all next time.